The Irish fire alarm standard requires the use of an external sound or strobe unit at the entrance to a building for the fire services to determine which is the best entrance to use to show where the fire alarm panel is. So this means the outside of the building has to have a sounder. The Cranford unit here comes with a 30-minute cutoff, which means after 30 minutes, if the sounder's continuously ringing, it cuts off, but the strobe continues to flash. So this is a requirement, kind of a in case you're in an area where people don't have access to the building, that you're not causing too much of a nuisance. You know, it's reasonable to assume if a building's on fire, fire services or emergency services or the property owner will have arrived within 30 minutes to turn the system off. So failing that, if it's an empty building left over a weekend, a factory, this kind of thing where you mightn't have occupancy, they want the sounder to cut off and the flasher to keep going just to indicate that there has been an alarm in the building. And this is the solution we use for that, which is the Cranford Controls sounder beacon with 30 minute cutoff. So neat unit. Again, we tend to stock these with deep bass. This is for decades we have installed this equipment ourselves, and while the shallow bass versions of these things tend to be pretty nice, by the time you've actually got your cables into it, terminated them and everything else, you're just so stuck for space that you're just causing problems for yourself. We have it, and we sometimes have the low profile units here as a, you know, just the back box, we'd have them separate. So if it is something that you absolutely desperately need, a shallow version of it, get in touch and we'll see if we can sort you out. So we like the deep bass. So again, here, they just to keep the round profile if you don't need the this for bottom entry. So again, the usual thing if you're externally mounting these, which is generally the only place we use these, is externally, because internally we just use the standard sounder beacon, because we don't mind if it keeps ringing. So you drill your own entry points in the bottom of that. Typically, if it's external, your drip loop, etc., to keep it IP65. But I do like that they provide you with this little slip here, that if you are installing them inside and you don't need the cable entry point in the bottom of it, you're coming straight into the back, you can slide that back in just to keep the unit neat. So you have your terminations here. It's a very small criticism, but the usual cable we use is 2x1.5 fireproof cable, fire tough, prismin, you know, no burn, whatever your flavor is, just make sure it's correct for your application. Your tone here is selected using your dip switches. So here you have the different tones, warbles, etc. That's all outlined in the leaflet that comes with it. And then where you're terminating into, whether it's tone one or tone two, will give you a different selection of tones. Nice little feature on this one is the anti-tamper locking screw is actually mounted here inside, so it's a bit easier. In a lot of these, the Sonos Klaxon one, it actually comes loose in the box, just in a small plastic bag. Not a big thing, but it's just a nice little touch, I find, with this. So yeah, I mean, that's the unit. The, you know, typical of all of these things, there's a selection of tones. You just pick whatever's adequate for your environment, whatever. You know, you need to keep the Irish standard certainly tells you that there should be a uniform tone throughout the building. So you have a lot of options there. And it kind of shows how you're terminating here and your dip switches for your tones, depending on what you're doing. So that's the Cranford Controls sounder beacon with 30-minute interrupt. Thanks.